Hey there, guys and gals. Melodic Symphony here, and we're coming back to roommates again. So, I really like how this is going so far, because it seems like this pathway is going to be based around, just from what I could see, it's going to be based around Sally showing Max how she lives life and trying to convince him to do such. And, that seems really interesting, to say the least. I did realize I made a mistake, and, I can do wall climbing here. God dang it. So I made a mistake. And that's a lot of active, so I'm going to try and replace some of these with the spontaneous. Because that means I'd have four and four, which is perfect. God dang it. I knew there was something I was missing. But, Oh, one thing that I'm going to miss about the Max and Rakesh playthrough is that I didn't have to do the higher pitch voices for the females that frequently. So my voice wasn't as strained all the time. But like after every session so far, it's been like, wow, my throat isn't having fun right now. But oh well. Last session wasn't so bad. The 30-minute one was, that hurt a lot. Ugh. I think I'm starting to get the hang of this class routine thing. After long days of work, some food sounds great. Time to hit the kitchen and find out how long until I can get some grub. The first thing I see in the kitchen is Sally staring right at me. Oh, hey, I was just checking on... dinner. No problem. Want to lend a hand? I could use some help with the tofu. Oh, man, veggie night again? I suppose I can help out, though. I don't know anything about cooking this stuff. The last time she was left alone with our food, it came out less than ideal. Let me put my stuff away and go wash up. I'll come down if I can, okay? Sounds good. Otherwise, I'll see you at dinner. Once I've got my hands washed, it's back down to the kitchen to give Sally a hand. Maybe together we can make this week's meal better than last week's. Welcome back, Max. Grab a spoon and stir the pasta, okay? You're the boss. Though, is this the same stuff as last week? Because that stuff was terrible. Oh no, I switched my brands. I even made myself some over the weekend, just to make sure. This stuff is much better than that last tofu. Plus, I'm not trying to pretend it's hamburger this time. I figure we'll get back to the basics this week. This time, fried tofu and portobello fettuccine alfredo. I could see Sally's mixing some kind of creamy sauce in a small pan. A pot is boiling on another part of the large stove. I grab a spoon and start to stir the pot of pasta. Let me know when that tofu starts turning brown so I can flip it, okay? This is a pretty amazing spread for all vegetables. Do you mind me asking why you decided to go vegan anyways? Well, it was an easy decision, really.
How so?
Well, I love animals. All animals. How does it make sense to eat something you love? I mean, I started looking into being a vegan because I didn't want to hurt any more animals. But when I looked into the health benefits, it became totally obvious.
Really?
Oh yeah, reduced chance of heart disease, less chance for diabetes. It's a very healthy diet all around.
Tell Sally she looks good. Well, I can certainly see the benefits are paying off.
Aw, thanks. Not that I was fishing for compliments, it really is a good diet.
I'm sure it is. After all, you show it off very nicely.
Oh, stop.
Oh yeah, that scored some points. Her cheeks are a little redder as she flips the frying tofu.
I guess you're not so bad yourself for meat eater.
Hey now, I do plenty of bacon ups every morning to get these abs.
Oh, gross, I don't even know what that is.
Well, I suppose it's a lot like a carrot on a stick. Hey, maybe I'll switch to carrots.
That's definitely a better idea, even if it's still weird.
We're both laughing as we drain the fettuccine and pour it into the pan with the white sauce. Alfredo.
Okay, you keep stirring the pasta. Make sure the mushrooms don't burn.
Okay.
Thanks for helping me out in here tonight. I know this is a different type of meal for you.
Oh, it's no problem.
It's just nice to see someone who doesn't automatically see something different and think it's bad. Hey, I like to try different things. Variety is the spice of life, right? That's a good attitude to have, I think. Look to the positive and try to avoid the negative. I'm used to people making fun of me for being a vegan, but it's about making a stand and showing the path to enlightenment.
I guess I can understand that.
We're all pretty different here, and we're different in different ways. Isabel and Rakesh are, well, even look at you and Anne, different. But we have things in common, you know? But we need to embrace that diversity. It's the path to truly capturing that harmonic energy that brings people together in understanding. I don't know if I buy into this whole energy thing of hers, but I can appreciate the sentiment.
Hey, I'm all about embracing diversity and otherwise.
Exactly. Okay, I think we're ready. Let me get the plates out to the table, and can you turn off the stove and tidy up a bit while I serve?
Will do.
I wonder what she meant about Isabel and Rakesh. Oh, it doesn't matter for now. I will clean up a bit, and as I hear the others grabbing plates and sitting at the table. A few moments later, I can hear Sally asking them if they like it. Ugh, utter silence.
Uh-oh.
Hey, come on out and grab a plate. They all really liked it. Great job, Max.
Heading out, I join the others to enjoy a great meal with my roommates.
And that's something this game really does well, are very sentimental things that seem to... they prove a point. And I think that's really interesting. A lot of sentimental values that prove a point. Thankfully, in this pathway, I don't have to do the Halloween thing. So, I don't have to read that. So that's like a 40-minute episode. Oh my god.
It's still a little weird, wandering around this place like it's my own home. I've only been here a few weeks, and I'm not used to the noises yet. For instance, I can hear a bunch of the others downstairs. I wonder what's going on in here. Well, it looks like Anne, Rakesh, and Sally have set up in the common room. There's also about 4 6-packs stacked on the table.
Hey, guys?
Oh, great. Hey, Max. We're just about to start playing King's Cup. Come join us.
A King's Cup?
It's a card game with drinking that Isabella showed us. Or maybe a drinking game with cards is a better term.
You know the rules forbid alcohol in here, right?
Paging Dr. Buzzkill. You're needed for an immediate phonectomy.
Oh, shut up, Max, before I dissect you.
Oh, Dominic, you should join in too. Does nobody listen to me around here?
I do my best not to.
Did I not just tell you to shut up?
We listen. We just think you're silly. Come on, Dominic. Loosen up. Besides, if we can't do it here, then we're just going to be forced to find somewhere else to do it. We'll be out on the campus, drunk and wild, talking about how our cruel ray threw us out of our own home.
It may not look very good.
Fine. Do whatever you like. Just don't come crying to me when the house authority kicks you all out. I can hear Dominic's door slamming from down here.
Come back and join us, Dominic.
That was fantastic. Where's Isabel to see him get put in his place?
I know, right? You'd think that since this was her idea, she'd have stuck around. But apparently her latest crush called and she had to go running.
Crush?
Oh, sorry. I meant boyfriend.
Sally's holding up air quotes around boyfriend. I
guess they haven't been together long. We'll see how long this one lasts.
Oh, so what does all this mean? Does Isabella have a boyfriend? I can't believe it. So, who's his crush?
Oh, I don't know. Some giant football guy. Chap,
or something like that.
Oh, great. Some huge muscle-bound oaf.
Okay, so it's just us then?
Yes, just we three. Four, if you would like to join us.
It's not like I've never played a drinking game before. They usually end up being pretty hilarious.
Hang on. Let me grab some stuff from my room, okay? If I'm not down in a minute, just get started without me.
I don't think I need to play this one. Let me go back up here. Week 2, Wednesday. No, I don't need to play this one. Just keep it.
You know, I'd meant to go back down. I was just going to lay down for a second. And next thing I knew, it's a couple hours later. Let me just... I'm clicking the wrong button. My eyes are barely open when I hear Dominic screaming at the top of his lungs. No, not in a chance. Not on your life. Well, that's interesting. Apparently something rubbed Dushnik the wrong way. I opened the door just in time to hear his slam again. Down in the common room, Sally and Rakesh are laughing. Anne just looks embarrassed. Hey, what's all the fuss about?
You guys are so mean.
Oh, come on. Those are the rules of the game.
Ugh, Sally's obviously got a few beers in her. Seriously, what happened?
The rules of the game dictate the holder of the queen may ask any question. And if you're not answering, you have to pay a penalty.
And when Dominic refused to answer, his penalty was to kiss Rakesh. He didn't like it.
This time, when Rakesh and Sally burst into laughter again, I'm right there with them. Sally has had clearly enough at this point, though, so I help Anne clean up while Rakesh helps Sally off to sleep. Just so incomprehensible when drunk people talk. Yeah, week two, Wednesday, we didn't need to do anything, so that's good. I didn't think so because I don't remember you ever losing points or gaining points with her in any of the options. I just wanted to double check because there's some strange random things you have to do on occasion, and it's just a pain. Oh, God. Class is going to begin any minute now, and I really need to get a move on. Well, then again, honestly, what's my rush? It's a pretty nice day out. Maybe I shouldn't be so bad to skip it. I don't know. Skip out sitting in a classroom? Heck, there are even people sitting in the quad eating and reading books. Wait, I think that one looks familiar. Is that Anne reading? Hey, Anne.
Oh, Max, hello. Come on over. I'm reading Ovid. I have a report due later this week.
Oh, okay, I can't remember. This one is like, I think this is one of the trick ones where if you say skip event, you actually talk to her because you're skipping class. And I don't want to do this whole thing yet because this is, again, part of her storyline. I think if I skip it, I'm skipping talking to her.
Who am I kidding? I can barely spell book, let alone read them. No way am I going to try to pretend to know what she's got going on over here. I wave at Anne, pointing towards my next class.
Sorry, I've got class. I'll catch you at the house, okay?
Sure thing. I'm glad you're going to class, Max.
Well, dodge that bullet. May as well get to class now, I guess.
Woo!
Week 2 Sunday. Not much time left in the weekend, and I haven't even gotten really anything done. I should probably call Memphis and set up some time with the band.
Memphis is my second in my band, Back Alley Flash. He plays the bass. He's been out looking for places we can play for the past couple of weeks, but we need to get together and jam for a while.
Are you crazy? Seriously? You've gone over the edge this time, you crazy control freak.
Have you forgotten that this is a college? I know you like to treat it like your own personal hookup bar, but you're supposed to be here to learn.
That's no excuse for taking our precious weekend time from us, and in the evening, some of us have lives to lead, jackass.
Apparently Dominic and Isabella are arguing about something. They're certainly being loud enough. I guess I can see what's going on. Then again, I kind of have things I should be doing.
Nope, screw it. I've got plans. I've been putting off practice for way too long.
Luckily, with those two yelling so loudly, no one notices me sneak out of the door.
I'll just sneak back in later tonight after practice, and I'm sure those two can figure this out on their own.
Okay. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching this episode. If you liked it, be sure to leave a like. Right, just comment on it. Talk about what you see. Subscribe. I'm not picky. Like, I love it when you guys talk about these things and comment. A lot of people have been commenting on the Katawa Shujo videos. And it's really nice to hear other people's opinions about the story. And that's something that I treasure with that Katawa Shujo series, so much so that I'm actually thinking about redoing them now with my voice, since I actually have a microphone that sounds decent. And if I do that, I don't want to seem like I'm just re-uploading the same thing. So once I do that, I may take down the old ones, but I'm not really sure what the preference would be. So I think, in the comments, how about you just say if you want me to do Katawa Shujo with voice, and just let me know, because I've got a couple people saying they want it, and then I've had a few people say that they liked it because there was no voice.
So, I don't know. It's very strange. Very strange. But, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a like, comment, or subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.